Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Welcome to our Little Mercy Church. Today we celebrate the Nativity of the Lord. Please rise and let's begin our celebration of the obvious.
Jesus, you are our peace. Sisters and brothers, listen to a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwell in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you, as at the harvest, as people make merry, dividing spoils. For the yoke that murdered them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every root that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for your flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder the Midian rests. They named him Wonder Counselor, God Hebrew, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Sisters and brothers, listen to the reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
In those days, a decree went out of Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was the governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled in heaven, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger."
And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Sometimes we don't realize that we have Lord to bring comfort into our lives. And today we have our time of meetings, listening to when we receive orders, guidance from other people. We like to fight. Oh, this is my right, this is my freedom. And we're not thinking that my right, my freedom might affect others. I do not understand the meaning of this. We can watch, we have been watching this movie, how the news have put us in this conflict. People who use masks, people who don't have been vaccinated, and we are in this constant conflict that we don't realize that we have lost our peace. Let peace be in your heart today. Put every conflict aside today. And as you find peace, you will find the joy of God into your heart. Because we forgot what we celebrate today. It's the birth of God. It's God that became human. Every year we do this. Every year we celebrate the peace. Did we go deep in this, in the understanding of this mystery? And is God and His creation colliding together? And is God coming to visit His creation and become one of us? He was put in this woman, in this virgin called Mary. The mystery of the creation of the divine. God becoming human, growing inside a body of a woman, and He will come into the world. The God of love, the God of peace, coming to meet His creation. And He will walk among us, and He will preach about love, peace, forgiveness, reconciliation. And through many centuries, we are repeating His word over and over.
peace, love, forgiveness, reconciliation. And today is the celebration of the moment. We should be peace in our heart. We should have joy in our heart today. Where we are. Where are our feelings? Are we happy? Are we excited to be alive? Do we understand the mystery of our own lives? You know, sometimes people don't understand. When God came to be one of us, He showed us that what He has made is wonderful. He came to say what He made because it was wonderful. It was worth it. We are worth it and we are wonderful. And we are never to see that. The mystery of the incarnation of God is revealed to us that the human race is the most wonderful thing that God has made. And because we don't understand our own humanity, we miss the target. We don't realize that mystery shows that the human race has been the most wonderful thing that God has made. That's why He became one of us. Not because we're low, not because we're not worthy. It's because we don't understand our own identity, who we are. God's children. Most wonderful thing that God has made the whole universe. So far, we know that we are the only creatures in the universe. We haven't found anybody else in the whole universe. The knowledge that we have is the human race, so far as the only living creatures in the whole universe. Until today. Maybe in the future, who knows what we will know. Today is the day of peace, love, and joy. May God be more in our hearts. May our Lord help us understand the mystery of our own salvation. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light of light, true God of true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us and for salvation came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate from Spirit and became man. For our sake He was crucified on the cross of Calvary. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of our Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeding from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son, the Lord and the Father, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in the Holy God, the Catholic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us confidently bring our needs and petitions to our loving Father.
Please respond. Lord, be with your people.
Lord, be with your people.
We pray for the church, the body of Christ on earth. Through our words and actions, may we bring the true presence of Christ to everyone we encounter. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, be with your people.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life. May more and more young people follow Christ faithfully in their vocation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may we hear.
We pray for Our Lady of Mercy Parish, that we will celebrate the presence of Jesus among us by renewing our commitment to living as His disciples. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may we hear.
We pray that the gift of the Son of God will renew love and unity in families that are separated by distance or discord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may we hear.
We pray for the poor and neglected who live among us. May we be a source of joy and support for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may we hear.
We pray for Soledad Hernandez, Concepcion Moya, Lourdes Martinez, Ana Gonzalez, Dan and Mary Foley, John Lowry, Erica Bezerril, Carlota Garcia, Gustavo Pina, John O'Connell, Xavier J. Lusada, Sylvia Mary, Kurt Jens, Veronica Jens, Antonio Romero, Reina Malave, Ida Santos, Emily Castello, and all the sick. May the presence of God in their lives bring them hope and consolation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may we hear from
our people.
We pray for the recently deceased, especially Ronald Nemkowski, Maria Aurora de Susara, that they may rest in God's peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may we hear from our
people. We pray especially for the people of Our Lady of Mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may we hear from our people. Loving God, as your Son and Son of God of course, He entrusts His disciples to the tender care of His Lord, and thus
form from His own suffering,
but we pray all those who live in Him. Help us now to raise His holy brothers and sisters, and to strengthen the body of Christ for us all. And we find comfort in His holy fathers, walk together in the confidence of Christ our Lord and one another. May the Holy Spirit guide us as man. Our God and Father, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated down. The usher will occupy to collect your offering.
Thank you.
God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
our God and our apostolic church.
May the oblation of this feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray. That through this most holy exchange, we may be found in likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For in the mystery of your word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God, love things invisible. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Communion with the
Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lourdes, Chrysogonos, John, and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints. We ask them through their merits and prayers. In all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept these oblations of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace. Command that we be delivered from eternal damnation. Count it among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve these offerings in every respect. Make it spiritual and effective, so they may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, give you thanks. He said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more gave you thanks. He said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
On the altar, see the most holy body and blood of your Son, and be
who have gone before us with a sign of faith, raised in the sleep in peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also your service, and those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant us some share, fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Nastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we see you into the company, not waiving our memories, granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, to sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy they should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Before we go forth to receive communion, just an invitation. The archer will walk and each pew put baptizes in your hands to receive communion. For those who are here for the first time, normally we are receiving communion in our hands. So go forward, put your hands together, show your hands to the minister, and they will put the body of Christ in your hands. Walk aside, put your mask, and you will eat the body and go right away to it. Thank you for your help. we have the Christmas bulletin. Please take one home. There are a lot of information there. And in the pathway, you can see the little toys there, the staff of the parish. You can see how many people are working in our office right now. So we continue our Christmas Mass today. While noon, we have been celebrating the Savior, our chapel, in Spanish, and 1 p.m. in Spanish here in our church. So today, 5:30 Mass is canceled, so please don't show up. Go and enjoy the Christmas day. But you have to be here tomorrow. So you are fulfilling one obligation today and tomorrow. So we hope to see you tomorrow for the continuation of Christmas. So today is 4 Christmas Day, and tomorrow we continue the Christmas celebration. So we hope to see you tomorrow for the regular classes. 7:45 in English and 8:15 in English too. So hope to see you. Our Lady of Clouds group invites you to a 3-night prayer from Tuesday, December 28th, to Thursday, December 30th, at 7 p.m. here in church. Everyone is welcome to this celebration. The solemnity of Mary, Mother of God, will be January 1st. The Mass schedule is as follows. December 31st, 2021, we're going to have a Hindu Mass at 5:30 p.m. January 1st, 2022, we have a Spanish Mass at 9:15, a bilingual 10 a.m. Mass in San Francisco Xavier, an English Mass at 11:15 here in our church, a Spanish Mass here at 1 p.m. with the celebration of Our Lady of the Clouds. So you can find information in the bulletin too. So we are forming a committee for our gala night or dinner nights. Our next night meeting will be December 29 at 7 p.m. in Guayaquil. Those who want to be part of this committee are welcome. We are trying to organize this every year. It will be our main celebration to raise money for our parish. And we hope you will help us with this. So the idea, as you know, everything is going up. Every single up, now the collection. So we will need your help. So we are going to have this event every year to help our parish with the finances. So again, we hope you will give us your support. Our youth group will meet January 2nd. All teenagers from age to high school are welcome to be part of this group. If you want to learn more about God and you want to learn more about your faith, please come to our meeting. The next meeting will be January 2nd at 3:30 p.m. in Ryan Hall. All the neighbors are welcome. The marriage and family groups invite to the community to restart a marriage and family ministry. Next, the first meeting this year will be January 9th from 3:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. in Ryan. All couples, families are welcome. If you want to strengthen your relationship with your family, please be part of this marriage and families group. Yeah, good support for all of us who are married and need to know more about our family relationships. So we want to give thanks to all the people who helped with the giving tree. And we were able to help 120 families, I think. So thank you for your support. We're still raising money for Father Zachariah in Tanzania. He's going to get around $10,000 donation to help him to build a church in his country. So thank you again for your support and generosity. Okay, so our gala night or dinner plans will be September 23rd, 2022. So it's going to be our Friday. So you will be able to buy your tickets. You can make payments for it, or you can pay the full amount of the ticket. More information will be found next week. So, hope to see you tomorrow from us. Merry Christmas again, and we have an announcement from our gospel.
shy of full complement ushers. We are asking people to exit their pews in this in an orderly fashion, maintaining social distance. You will exit the pews from the starting with the furthest pew from me. So when the people in that pew have exited, then the next pew will exit, people in the next pew, and so on and so forth. To help maintain social distance, please don't exit your pew until the pew behind you is empty of your parishioners, your brothers and sisters. And now for the usual thing that we do for exiting the center aisle. We do not use the center aisle at all. We are using the side aisles to exit. Everyone exits the east doors, through the glass doors, out to the plaza, and then to Troy Street. Section 1, which is aligned with the statue of the state of the fire, will exit by the south aisle. Section 2, which is aligned with the handle, wherever I stand, will exit by the south center aisle. Again, no one exits by the center aisle, do not leave by the center aisle. Section 3, which is aligned with the deacon's chair, will exit by the north center aisle. And section 4, which is behind the choir, will exit by the north aisle against the far wall over there, the north wall. And again, everyone leaves by the east doors. Thank you for your attention. Thank you for gathering to celebrate this Eucharist or Christmas Day. And thank you for participating on our broadcast. Everyone, enjoy your Christmas. Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by the participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity, may through our honorable way of life become worthy of union with Him, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, Alleluia.